What's he doing?
He wants you to stomp on him. He wants you to prove how tough he is.
I killed him! If I go down, Socrates, I'm taking you down with me!
Wait for it. Wait for it.
You're invincible!
What is wrong with me?
Nothing is wrong with you, Norm. You're special. I share the same trait. I, too, can speak to our human visitors.
You can talk to them, too?
I can. Polar bears are icons of the Arctic, Norm, and an icon with a voice can be very powerful indeed. For now, just know that what you and I have is a great gift. One day, you'll truly understand. Our land is vulnerable, and we're responsible.
What's up, Stan?
I only caught the tail end of it. But I made some money off your failed hunt today, big bro. Let me give you some advice, bro. Act with your stomach and not your heart. Oh, my 5 o'clock is here. Excuse me, Normie.
I don't know why you spend so much time and energy on these tourists. They're ruining it up here.
Au contraire, mon frère. As Dad always says, if humans come to our land and clap, they can't come to our land and crap. Give them a scene, the Arctic stays clean. Let's give these people what they came 1,000 miles to see. A show! And go!
Your grandfather had a saying, panem et circenses. He meant it's easier to distract ourselves with food and entertainment than think about real problems.
What happened to Grandpa Socrates? Did he really just disappear?
I think your grandpa knew something was happening and tried to fight it. And it looks like that something is happening.
Holy icicle! Is that a human house?
Humans are invading our land, and you are a polar bear who can speak to humans. You're the only one who can do something about this.
Norm, you are not to go anywhere near there, you hear me?
Snuck in! Norm, you shouldn't go onto property that doesn't belong to you. You should know better. Besides, I'm sure the house you're referring to is simply a research hut. Now, there is plenty of ice to go around. Just stay away from there. Far away. And for the love of salmon, no more talking human. You got me?
Norm, don't listen to them. They're just furry robots sitting in their ice cubicles obeying the rules, pretending nothing bad's ever gonna happen. But you can change the rules. You're seeing the future. They're just living in the past. You can find a new way. Don't just dance for the humans. Fight for our home instead.
Hi, Elizabeth.
Hi.
Jeez, it's like pure ice up here. An accident waiting to happen, you know? I mean, somebody should really do something about this, huh? It's the most amazing thing. I gotta tell all my SEAL buddies. You press the lever, the water goes up. Oh, hey, guys. Come on in. Help yourself to some fur balls in the fridge.
Wait, what do you mean, another talking bear?
Oh! Okay, Vera, you're a problem solver. When you're faced with a problem, what do you usually do? You solve it! If only I had some seals and ice and, are there penguins up here? Oh no! A polar bear! I think he's charging me! Is that bad? Look it up on the internet!
It says when confronted with a polar bear, assert dominance and stand your ground.
I don't think it's working.
Let me call you back, honey. Mommy has an idea. Love you. Mr. Greene, meet Norm of the North. Norm is just a consummate actor. He certainly looks the part, and he even brought Arctic lemmings.
Yeah, he's pretty, and I feel scared. Ooh, ah. Can Norma play King of the Arctic?
I'm with the viewer. I'm scared of police. Guess what, Toots? I'm above the law. Welcome to the cold, hard world of big business. You sound just like the investors.
That has to be done correctly, Greene.
Please, wake up and smell the profits. Not to mention that after Norm of the North's announcement today, approval is a guarantee. Let's use the Arctic to sell the Arctic. Booyah!
It's beautiful, Mom, but what will it look like when you, Mr. Greene, build all those houses there? You're changing the Arctic. Change isn't always good. Anyway, Mommy, I was researching the effects of human activity in the Arctic, and the research is irrefutable. It will destroy the Arctic, and possibly the rest of the Earth as we know it. Great to meet you, Norm. Quite a costume you found yourself.
Yes, hi, Mr. Greene. Sorry I didn't pick up before.
Your mom is very good at her job, Olympia.
I know. Sometimes I wish she wasn't so good at her job if it meant she got to spend more time with me. Oh, you have lemmings! Uh-huh. The smallest animals in the Arctic. Please, I know exactly what you're doing, Norm. You're saving the Arctic. You're home. So I'm thinking, maybe we can work together. And you can save my home in the process.
Like you and me, I tell you, enough is damn it!
Yes, I am the king of the Arctic, and the king is hungry. Sustenance! Hark! Seal hark, I say! A real polar bear always does his own stunts. Come here and feel my Arctic wrath. Tenga!
So you're here for the Greene Holmes audition. King of the Arctic, I take it? Well, you certainly look the part of a bear. That costume is exquisite.
It's a little something I threw together.
Yes. I thought I had this role locked up, but now my bear suit is ruined. Oh, I'll never get this one. Yes, I am a phenomenal actor, but I can't compete with you. Such authenticity. You even smell like a polar bear. Me? I smell like macaroni and sweet vermouth. Now go and get that part!
We have an unusual guest today who is here to tell us about his home, the Arctic, and how you can make it your home too. Without further ado, Norm of the North! So, Norm, you're here for a very special mission. Would you like to tell us what it is? Ladies and gentlemen, I think our furry friend's a little nervous.
Oh, you're a real bear? Who can speak?
Yeah, who would have thought? But I need to come clean about who I really am and what I'm really doing here.
We know exactly who you are. You're Norm of the North. I am Pablo, and this is my investment group. If I know Greene, he'll have the homes transported tonight. Norm, you have my word. Now get me out of this deal.